First of all, thank you so much, John. Thank you so much to organizer for the kind invitation. It's a great pleasure to be here. And I follow the last speeches, and I try to give you a different point of view, not because I'm not agree with all the distinguished guests and colleagues and speakers, but because I think if we start not from academy, as John, you said just some minutes ago, but from reality, and we focus on politics, I think we have a little problem. Houston, we have a problem. Brussels, we have a problem. Because we can discuss about emission, the level of emission, the number of emission. That is very interesting, important. But the real question today is, what is the mission of Europe, not the emission of Europe? Because we stay in the debate in Europe with a very great attention about the numbers, the average, good, very interesting. But if we don't open a discussion about what type of Europe we will build in the next years, will be impossible to play a role, because our numbers are absolutely less important than USA numbers, than the Chinese numbers. So the first thing is, what is sustainability today? I believe in the value of words. It's easy to believe in the value of words in Greece, because there are eternal words. Please, democracy come from Greek, old Greek history, and means people, the power for the people. People of the power is a song, but the concept is the same. Philosophy is an eternal word, is an word that came from the friends of wisdom, and it came from old language in Greece. And there are a lot of eternal words. I joke with my friend, American friend, when I was prime minister, because I come from Florence, and also America is eternal city, is eternal world, but this word come from a Florentine guy, Amerigo Vespucci. So I started with an official speech with, my dear Vespuccian people. They look me, Vespuccian, what it means? Because just to understand how give the name to the words, it's crucial. Sustainability is the same word in the last 10 years, not. 10 years ago, sustainability was used only for financial reasons. And please, we have to remember exactly 10 years ago when German Chancellor used this expression to attack the Greece government and the Greek government, and also in part Italian government. The European guys, and particularly German guys, attacked the lack of the sustainability in finance. Now, we know we won this battle, also if we have a lot of things to do, reducing debt, et cetera, et cetera. But we change also the meaning about the word sustainability. And 10 years ago, German guys talk about sustainability in finance, but they closed nuclear plants in Germany with the most stupid mistake did by German government for sustainability. And that is the same. They decide to invest in Nord Stream 2. And they broke the sustainability in Europe with this decision. And some of us tried to block that decision and tried to change position. So what means? Sustainability is not eternal words. Sustainability changed. 5 years ago, European girl, European woman, Greta, explained to us the importance to invest in a new life of sustainability, particularly about environment. But today, Greta expressed just some weeks before the United Nations Summit in September in New York City, I'm pro-nuclear. Everything changed about sustainability. And I believe now, after war in Ukraine, so 10 years ago, 5 years ago, now, everything is changed about the sustainability. What means to, 1 year ago, nobody think possible to discuss about a new life, not only for gas or for fossil, but for the idea of old energies. We have to combine together, because sustainability change week by week, month by month, year by year. And I arrive to the point very quickly. First, we have to give a a very important approach. We have to have a very important approach about sustainability. But I believe in the next 5, 10, 15 years, we will change again the idea of sustainability. Sustainability will be important for food, will be important for healthcare, will be important for demography. Mark remembered us before the numbers of demographic change around the world, China, India, Africa, everything will change in the next years. And so we have to fight today to have a different approach to sustainability, more pragmatic and less ideological. Second, and the final point, I think, of course, sustainability is a point of geopolitics today. Without a capacity to look at the questions about energy, and I arrive to the point probably John will explode in the next dialogue. If we don't understand that geopolitics is really connected and related to sustainability, particularly in energy, we don't understand what happened today. First of all, thinking about the USA, they change every position, for example, for Venezuela. They change everything. Thinking about, of course, Russia and the Ukraine, but also the relation between some European countries, it's correct. We continue to pay the energy 10 times USA, 10 times China, as before you expressed in the panel before us, but also Norway. In the last year, Norway, a European country, increased the value of billion of euro from 20 to 200 billion from gas. So we have to have a strategy in politics. And I finish really. What means today sustainability for me? We have to give a vision to Europe. And paradoxically, Greece and Mediterranean today are a crucial point. Because finally, the people understand that we cannot continue to have only one point, one client, who is Russia. Was a mistake to close the nuclear plant, but was a mistake to open to work for Nord Stream 2. That means we have two different ways, and both arrive in the Mediterranean and are very interesting for Greece and in part also for Italy. The first is the relation with the Middle East, and you, with the minister, discussed before. We cannot open now the discussion, but I believe that is the key point for a lot of reasons, also for the value and the price. The second is for Africa. And so, John, from Africa to Italy and to Greece and to Spain. So I arrive to point of start. I start from mission of Europe and not emission of Europe. Because we follow the technocrats of Brussels, is the number. We close our market 2035 and we give a very good gift to China because we lost a lot of position in the ranking. The real question is, Europe will be able to have a vision not for the next 10 hours because we have to do the next post on Instagram, on next tweet, and so we think only about day by day. We will able to have a vision for the next 10 years, and so we'll be able to change position and approach of our continent becoming a great hub for new energies, but also a great hub of transformation and change about global energies. This is the point. Paradoxically, Greece and Italy are crucial and central here. And if you think, 10 years ago, we were crucial for migrants. Sustainability was a problem for migrants, for the people who arrived from the Greece into Greece and to Italy. Now, paradoxically, the new pipeline, the new change could give a new centrality to Mediterranean and maybe explain to Europe we have to change the model of sustainability's idea, because in the last 10 years, the people who explain to us what is the truth make a lot of mistakes, maybe too much for the future of the next generation of Europe.